this is the first video of this semester in dynamics. So what we have seen just today is a summary of the mass moment of inertia. Last lecture we were discussing about the importance of mass moment of inertia and the importance of the material that the mass moment of inertia is made of, because the density is important and we know that the mass is going to be the main variable, and also the distribution of both or that mass, that in the dimensions involved. And obviously, if we have a very special shape, not saying regular, we have to solve integrals. But for that, you have software. You have your geometric modeler, like solid edge, rho e, katia, whatever. In this course of dynamics, we are going to solve problems on the plane, like this one. And for that, we will be using some regular bodies for which we have tables that give you the mass moment of inertia. But there's a thing with these tables, is that they have some formula for local axis of these rigid bodies. What you have to do is just to compare what is the axis that you need in your problem. For instance, it is a disk placed on this plane. And on the table, we have three formulas. We have to choose the axis Z that we need for this problem. It's the same for this thin plate and for a slender rod. If you have three local axes, but you place it on the plane, and maybe you will need one of those three formulas. Okay, there's another concept that you need to remember from statics, and that is the parallel axis theorem. Maybe you will need mass moment of inertia with respect to O when you already have the formula for C. These are two axes that are perpendicular to our plane, separated by a perpendicular distance D. Recalling from statics, the formula for the parallel axis theorem and adapting it to dynamics is something like this. The new mass moment of inertia with respect to O will be the mass moment of inertia with respect to the mass center plus the mass times the square of the distance. Okay? So that's a very simple concept that you need to remember from statics that we apply here in dynamics. And we will also solve problems involving some combination of regular shapes. For instance, in this problem, when I have a thin disk with a slender rod, you need to combine the two bodies. And probably you will need the mass moment of inertia of this pendulum with respect to O, the center of rotation, an axis passing through O. You need to apply the parallel axis theorem. And in a general form, the parallel axis theorem looks like this. It's the summation of the parallel axis theorem for each of the bodies. Okay? So now you are able to solve problems. You need to go back to your textbook. There's a list of problems, like problem 13 to problem 23, your chapter 17 of Professor Hibbler's book. Well, before we close today's summary, let me pass. Let's flip the classroom like this. The mass center, that's important for some problems. And you learn in the statics how to do this, but if you don't remember, the formula is very simple. And you can just see it here. The sum of each mass times the distance to a reference point divided by the sum of masses. That will give you the y bar that is needed for the general mass center of the same pendulum. Okay? So, very simple concepts, but you need to start doing some problems. See you next time.